I'm Sally Kidd near Washington. The federal government issues new guidelines to help school districts respond to the H1N1 virus.
Plus, we now know what killed TV pitchman Billy Mays. The surprising autopsy results are next.
At first, it was shot with me. I really didn't believe it.
Her artwork stolen from a downtown art studio, but then came good news.
Good everybody, I'm live here in Franklin, North Carolina. We're talking a barbecue festival, and we're talking places from all over the country, teams. Hello, you. Oh, is that for me? Oh, check this out. Beth and Nigel, we're talking some good barbecue. Crab cakes and ribs.
I'm so hungry.
Oh, can
right
you
now.
Smell it all the way back in Greenville?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk barbecue, we'll talk weather coming up next, so don't go away.
Between the fried fish and the last story and the barbecue, no. My stomach's going to growl loud enough for the microphone. Okay, first, today's winning midday numbers from the South Carolina Education Lottery. 2095.
And your pick 3950. Jimmy, you don't have food over there, do you?
Unfortunately, no, but a half rack would be pretty good right about now, Nigel. Thank you very much. We did have some interstate problems earlier this afternoon. A lot of those problems have cleared up, but some problems on Pelham Road near the bridge above Interstate 85. An accident blocking up some lanes on the Pelham Road Bridge right now. Highway patrol units are headed to the scene. Doesn't appear to be a serious problem, but certainly will cause some delays. A couple of wrecks in Spartanburg County working right now. Highway 150 at Highway 176. Also another accident working in Spartanburg County, this one on Highway 9 at Wall Road. But once again, interstate problems earlier. No major problems for the interstates this afternoon, and that includes 85 at I-26. This traffic update brought to you by Harris Carpets, Flooring America of Anderson, family owned since 1947. With WYFF News 4 Traffic, I'm Jimmy White.